On Rewind the 60s today, we're concentrating on 1964 and 1965 and hearing some more personal stories of people who lived through some of the biggest social changes in our recent history.
They'd rejected the styles and tastes of their parents, but there was a need to belong, so young people turned to gangs to give them a visible cultural identity. Mods and rockers were born and came to symbolise two very different ideologies. Get your motor running.
Head out on the highway. These were your mates, like, as you was growing up, and you got to a certain age and certain things become different. For me, it was motorbikes. I wanted to know how they worked, and when they broke down, I wanted to fix them. Whereas, like, one of the lads I'd be growing up with, he wanted to look good on a, you know, for the girls or whatever. Yeah, he wanted to look smart. They're just different mindsets.
As the Teddy Boys grew up, rockers took their place. They defined their style through white American rock and roll stars of the 50s, like Elvis. Motorbikes, jeans, and decorated leather jackets were essential. Woo, come
on, everybody. My first recollection of becoming a rocker was when I was 14 years old. One of the lads in the flats I lived in Battersea got captured by a woman, and he had to give his motorbike up. And part of his stuff that he gave away was a leather jacket. And the jacket I got, it had, I still remember it now, it had tassels on it. And on the back of it, it had like a graveyard scenes and skull and crossbones and little bits, and it had a poem on it, which was picked out in studs, and I still remember the poem. It's "Death be to all thee who ride with me" on the back of it, right? And he gave me this jacket, and I was, wow, you know, I mean, it's like, that's almost like armour. I'm slipping and I'm sliding, peeking
and I'm hiding, bent all a long time ago. To the mods, rockers were out of date.
Rockers, to us, they were very strange. We called them greasers, rockers. They always looked, or so we thought, scruffy and dirty and covered in Brill Cream. Any mod at the time would have said that the rockers were their sworn enemies, you know.
With such different styles and attitudes, it wasn't surprising the two groups didn't always get on. On the May Day bank holiday of 1964, tensions rose to a head, and the mods and the rockers clashed in Brighton.
What caused all this trouble yesterday?
Boredom.
On whose part?
Well, on both. They started, you know what rockers are like, don't you?
I went down to Brighton twice. There was literally thousands of mods spread out on the beach having a good time. I mean, you know, playing music and transistor radios, all the rest of it. And every now and again, someone would jump up and shout out "Grease" or "Rockers," and the whole lot would rise as one and start running up the road. People pushed over and things knocked over. And I know there were some windows broken and things. There were people arrested and there were a few fights and skirmishes, but it was all very minor for what I could see. But, of course, when we got back and read the papers on the following day, it was a different story altogether, like a story of these mass riots and mods and rockers fighting and the police going in mob-handed and all that, and it just got blown out of all proportion. Boom, boom, boom,
boom. Prior to 64, the image of the rockers wasn't great anyway, so after the battles, the mods actually come out worse in terms of their image, because up until then, they was always seen as the clean-cut, decent lads, and we was like, you can't come in here with your leather jacket on. So in a way, it kind of like rebalanced that for us.
It didn't bother us to be called hooligans and all the rest of it, because half of us probably were anyway, so it wasn't something we were particularly bothered about. I think that the media got hold of this and blew it up, and I think that allied with several other things like the commercialism of the mod thing by a fashion industry was the beginning of the end for the mod movement. Everyone was a mod suddenly, you know. It was a street thing originally. It had come from the streets. Once it became commercialised, I think that was the end of the whole thing. Don't go, don't.
Rockers had some influence on punk rock bands in the 1970s. Mods found themselves split between joining the culture of swinging London or becoming skinheads. John and Len still look back with fond memories.
We're that much older and that much wiser, and, you know, I never forgot the era, I never forgot the period. I tried to recreate some of it by organising and putting together a Rockers reunion. It kind of like reinvigorated it. But it is literally camaraderie now, where you've survived as well as me, because so many ain't it with us now, you know.
These days, I think mods and rockers are pretty friendly, you know. I often see a group of mods down the road followed by a group of rockers. They get together and reminisce about old times, but I still hate them. Please don't go.